Hi friends, it's Miss Susannah again from Go Bananas Dancing. Welcome to part two of today's Let's Move and Play Ballet class. We are gonna go back to where we left off, and you may remember we were spelling out the word ballet and then doing steps for each letter in the word ballet, and we ended on L for leap, and now we're at L, and you'll see I wrote a word. It is, can you read? Left. The word is left. A lot of times in ballet, we start dancing on our right side, with our right side of our body. Well, even though I write with my right hand, I'm actually better at dancing on the left, with the left side of my body. So we're gonna do something, and we're gonna start on the left, and then we're gonna do the right. So do you know which is your left side and which is your right? I'm gonna face the other way, right? This is your left, right? You can do the thing where you make an L with your hand, and then you remember that's your left, right? L is for left. That's your left side. Okay, so I'm gonna face you, which might get a little confusing, but you'll know I'm doing my left. So what can we do? What ballet step can we do? Oh, I know. Let's do a passe, right? You bring your toe up near your knee. Passe. You might wanna have your arms in second position to help you balance. And we're doing it on the left first. Passe. Now, try one on your right. Passe. Fantastic. All right, the next letter in the word ballet is E. Oh, I have a good ballet step that begins with the letter E. It is échappé. Échappé begins with the letter E, and you'll see this little thing over the last E. That's an accent that helps the E make the sound A. Échappé. This is when our legs escape from one another. It's a kind of jump. We've done it before. Remember? Let's go to music. Jump out. Jump in. Jump out. Jump in. Oh, that is a fun one. Okay, we're at our last letter of the word ballet. It is the letter T. T is for tendu. Tendu is when we point our foot. I think it literally means to stretch. You stretch your leg nice and straight and then point your toe at the end. So, tendu is something we do a lot in ballet. And let's put on our music again. All right, let's do our tendus to the side. Hopefully you can see my feet. Bring your arms to second position. Point your toe to the side. Your leg is nice and straight, toe pointed. Say tendu. Excellent. Bring your foot back. Tendu to the other side, nice and straight, toe pointed. Say, tendu. Excellent. And you'll notice, oh, I started on the right. Like I said, we usually start on the right. All right, let's give ourselves a big clap, yay! We dance steps for every letter in the word ballet. Okay, so friends, now, we're gonna do a fun dance, and it begins with the letter B. If you watched part one, you know that I was talking about the letter B is going to be something we talk is going to be something we talk about a lot today. Here is a word that begins with the letter B. Do you know this word? Let's spell it first. B O O T S. Spells boots. Do you have a pair of boots? Maybe you do, maybe you don't. Maybe someone in your family does. Boots are great for a rainy day, like today in Virginia, or for a snowy day. Maybe it's snowing where you live. There is still snow in April in some parts of the US. And boots are also just fun to wear when you want to look good, right? Cowboy boots. Okay, so we're going to dance to a song called Boots. It's by the Laurie Berkner Band. And this is a fun one. I am going to pull it up. I'm going to tell you about it. Whoops, wrong song. We are going to... Hold on just a sec. All right, here we go. On your black boots.
In my black boots, I stomp around in my black boots. In my boots,
stomp, stomp.
In my boots,
stomp, stomp.
I stomp around in my boots.
B O O T S, boots.
B O O T S,
brown boots. In my brown boots, in my brown boots, I stomp around in my brown.
Stomp, stomp.
In my boots.
Stomp, stomp.
I stomp around in my boots.
B O O T S. Boots.
B O O T S.
Frog boots. In my frog
Fantastic.
Boots. In my frog boots. I jump around in my frog boots. In my boots.
Ribbit, ribbit.
In my boots.
Ribbit, ribbit.
I jump around in my boots.
B O O T S.
Dancing boots.
Perfect.
In my dancing boots. In my dancing boots. I dance around in my dancing boots. In my boots. In my boots. I dance around in my boots.
B-O-O-T-S. Boots. B-O-O-T-S.
Rain boots. In
Fun.
My rain.
Friends. Very nice. Okay, so let's talk a little bit more about the letter B. You saw before my favorite book, On Your Toes, A Ballet ABC by Rachel Isadora. We didn't look at the page yet for the letter B. We looked at A for arabesque. What's the B in this book? It is backstage. Ooh, and this music is by Beethoven. That begins with the letter B, but this version is actually by the Tiny Boppers. That's another word that begins with the letter B. Going back to backstage, you can see these ballerinas, begins with B, are backstage. On the stage, there's a man and a woman doing some ballet dancing in a show. They've already danced in the show. So the next time they go on stage, they're going to do their curtain call, which is when you come out and you curtsy, if you're a girl ballet dancer, and you bow, begins with B. If you're a boy, also begins with B, ballet dancer. So let's do that part of our ballet class, where we do our curtsies and our bows. It's called our reverence. And let me turn the music down a little bit.
Let's begin with a dance with our arms. A port-a-bras. Bra, B-R-A-S in French means arms. So stand up nice and tall. Let's get in our first position. Make room for that slice of birthday cake between your feet. Here we go. Girl ballet dancer, tendu to the front. Do a nice ballet curtsy. If you're a boy ballet dancer, do your bow. Let's all do this. We're gonna do one of my favorite dances where we pretend to be, can you see him back there? Bananas. And that word of course begins with the letter B. So you may have done this with Miss Susannah before. Here is how we do it. I originally learned this at a story time at the library and I've changed it a little bit to make it good for dance class. I mean, that was good before too. Okay, so here we go. You're a big, tall banana. And we say, bananas unite. Bananas split. And we share bananas. Share, share bananas. Yeah, we share bananas. Share, share bananas. And we peel bananas. Peel, peel bananas. Yeah, we peel bananas. Peel, peel bananas. Then we eat bananas. Eat, eat bananas. Then we eat bananas. Eat, eat bananas. Then we go bananas. Go, go bananas. Yeah, we go bananas. Go, go bananas. Friends, that is so fun. Do you know what it means to go bananas? It means to get really silly and really excited. Let's do it with some music this time, right? Ready? Go bananas. Let me turn it up.
If you're feeling kind of stuck and you just can't shake it, you need a fresh new plan, but you just can't make it. Well, don't give up, nah. Don't you quit. Come on and loose to a banana.
Oh, we should do a little bit more of our ballet, right? Let's do some shots. Here we go. Oh, my friends, thank you so much for dancing with me and for going bananas. I hope you have a wonderful evening. Please come do a movement story time with me on Friday, and we'll do this class again next Tuesday. Bananas, unite! Bananas, split! Still here. Bye.